Hello again, everyone. I am the Rabble Rouser, and if you're watching this, this is the second half of a Five Nights at Freddy's PSA. Because knowledge is power. So we're on night three. This is the night that Freddy actually starts to move. And we hear the phone guy telling you about going limp, which, if you watched the last one, didn't work for me. Chica's already gone. Fox is already poking out.
Hello, hello. Hey, you're doing great. Most people don't last this long. I mean, you know, they usually move on to other things by now. I'm not implying that they die. That's not what I meant. Anyway, I better not take up too much of your time. Things start getting real tonight. Hey, listen, I had an idea. If you happen to get caught and want to avoid getting stuffed into a Freddy suit, try playing dead. You know, go limp. Then there's a chance that maybe they'll think that you're an empty costume instead. Then again, if they think you're an empty costume, they might try to stuff a metal skeleton into you. I wonder how that would work. Yeah, never mind. Scratch that. It's best just not to get caught. Okay, I'll leave you to it. See you on the flip side.
Alright, so, yeah. That was the whole go limp tip from him. I'm surprised that Bonnie hasn't left yet. Yeah, Foxy tends to be pretty active rather quickly. And, something else that I wanted to mention. Now that Freddy's able to move tonight, he has a set pattern. He goes from the show stage to here, to here, to here, to here, and then finally here. And if he moves again, you will not be seeing him, because he never appears right outside your door. Uh-oh. Okay. Oh, there's Chica. It's unique that it's only Bonnie and Foxy that I have to have concern about tonight. Sounds like Chica could have moved into the kitchen, because I heard a little bit of noise there. Alright. Nope. Right in the bathroom. And I think it's pretty safe to say that Bonnie only goes through this door, Chica only goes through this door. Same with Foxy on this side, and Freddy on this side, unless you ran out of power, then Freddy appears on this side. There's Chica again. And that's Foxy's second animation, where he's getting ready to run. Another thing to notice, Chica doesn't have two sets of teeth. They gave her teeth on her bill for some reason, and the inside teeth are the endoskeleton. So yeah, they didn't do that to try to be inaccurate, it's just another thing to be horrified about. And so, yeah, we're going to want to keep an eye on those two, and Bonnie hasn't moved yet. Chica might right... Yep. So as you can see Chica plainly right there. Bonnie still stays right here, but the only time you can see him when he's at the door is the silhouette back there. And Chica tends to like to hang out by your door. But, strangely enough, left, making it rather ironic. So she's back there. I think it's unique that Bonnie hasn't moved yet. Yeah, the way I thought that Chica was near my room is because I heard the footfalls. And so, we have to be ready for both now. I'm just gonna focus on Foxy. That might be a bad thing. Alright, it might have been blocked out a little bit, but Freddy did move. And there he is. Yeah, when Freddy moves, all you see is his eyes. Ooh, that was a bad move. So yeah. Just gonna have to wait for the laughter to appear again before we can know what sound he makes when he moves. He still hasn't moved. I'm actually shocked. Another thing to note is that if you constantly look where Freddy should be, then he actually takes a longer time to move to the next station. I don't know, I guess he's shy. There's Bonnie. Chica was right over there. Yeah, right now it'd be stupid for me to go, oh boy. Okay. I think that music you're hearing right now is also if Chica is in the kitchen. Ah, if you heard that laughter, that means that Freddy moved. Except I keep hearing footfalls and it's making me nervous. So there's Freddy right there. Yeah. The phone guy said Freddy likes to hide in the dark, so he's usually rather hard to see. I like it because it seems to be an intimidating factor with Freddy. The big man himself. You never know where he could strike from. Why the fuck has Foxy not moved yet? I keep hearing footfalls. I usually take that as... Alright, Bonnie is in the kitchen. Freddy is still over there. Okay, Bonnie is right next to our door. Fortunately, at this point, we just have to hear the footfalls and... Oh boy. Yeah, if you can tell right now, I'm pretty nervous. I honestly don't know how... Oh boy. The footfalls come off on your end, but it's pretty clear here. Chica's just back there. Freddy hasn't moved. Oh, right. Yep. Silhouette shows that Bonnie is still there. And you hear the laughter, and now you can hear Freddy in the kitchen. I think Bonnie might... Yeah, Bonnie did leave. Alright. 8% power. Foxy still hasn't moved. Oh boy, I tell you, if he moves now, then that'll be all of my power. And then we'll have to rely on Freddy taking his time. He can take quite a bit of time playing a song, or... after the song's over, he can take his time getting to you and screaming in your face. Shit. Alright. There's night 3 down. Now on to night 4, and this is basically the strategy you should follow for every single night. There are 3 things you should do with certain circumstances changing. Put up the camera, look at where Freddy is and where Foxy is. Put down the camera, check the lights.
Those suits in the back room.
So yeah, those noises there are just from the phone call, and it's assumed that phone guy is in fact dead. So the reason why we look at Foxy and Freddy, only and then check the lights, is the fact that watching both of them pauses their movement towards your door. So yeah, I'm being pretty hectic here. The only thing that you really need to change from this night is that, well, if Freddy is in the camera right over here, then you always close the door before you check on Foxy. You close the door, check the camera, turn the door, turn off the cameras, and then open the door. So I'll give you a quick rundown. You check the lights. I do it more often because I hear footfalls. Close the door, check on Foxy, open the door. Because Freddy doesn't show up here, I've already mentioned. And in fact, if you put the camera up when he's right outside your door and you hear laughter, that means he's out. And yeah, I believe if you do any of the action, like pull up the camera, use any of the door lights or anything like that, then he'll kill you. Another thing to note is that there are never two animatronics out at the exact same time. So if Bonnie or Chica is in the room where Freddy is in, their visualization will take precedence. So if Bonnie ever decides to move and Freddy doesn't... Wait. Okay. Another thing I like to do is I always like to check on Foxy right when the cameras are up, in case I have to take care of him right away. So yeah, now you know the secret to taking care of Five Nights at Freddy's, and I'll give it to you, there's a element of luck to it as well. Alright, Foxy left, you close the door, you check on here, so he gets there faster. As soon as the door opens, or as soon as the door's knocked upon, then you can close it. Check. I don't know why you still hear knocking when you open the door and Foxy doesn't just kill you outright, but hey. Oh, and shoot, I forgot to take a look at the power level, because it should be that it dropped a bit. Oh, fudge your knuckles. Well, here comes Chica. Alrighty. Let's give Night 4 another try, shall we? Forgive me for that, I was drinking some water and got some ice. So yeah, those are your eyeballs and your teeth right there. Popping out of the front of the mask. Let's give that another old college try. Man, the first time I did this, I did fantastically. This time, not so much, and I'm starting to look like I don't know what I'm talking about. But this strategy, I promise you, does work. I mean, hell, if you've seen some of the big names do it, like... I'm pretty sure you can guess who I'd reference. But, yeah, that's essentially what they did. The only thing is, I've played this game enough times where it really doesn't scare me that badly. So, you know, I'm honestly surprised none of them have left yet. I don't even think I'm gonna bother checking the door lights until they're gone. But this is another example of randomization. Believe me, the fact that none of them have moved and it's been a decent while is just something I never really expected on night 4. Still no. I'll be honestly shocked if I make it at 1 AM and they're all still there. It is 1 AM and they have not moved. That is fascinating. Oh! Two of them moved. And Freddy was staring at me. Randomized chance that Freddy will stare at you. Which is another intimidating factor I do love. So yeah. Now we'll want to check the lights. Because we know for a fact two of them are gone. Also, you don't want to take too much time on the cameras. Just a quick update on them, and then back out, because I think that's what killed me. But if there's the chance that Freddy has moved past the bathrooms and the kitchen, I will attempt to show where he is. Although that'll hopefully be rather far into the night. Well, it probably will be, because this way he doesn't move as often. Alright. Audio clue shows that Chica, is in the kitchen. So we really don't need to check her light. Don't hear plates moving around, so check both. Rather strange that I'm only hearing it when the camera is up. I heard footfalls, but I'm going to check that quick. Yeah, I'm probably doing this way faster than need be, but losing that first time really got me. Yeah, as you can see, Foxy, like, I think it was night 3, popped out his head rather quickly. It's 2 AM and he still hasn't moved. Alright. Nothing doing there. Oh yeah, and the night 5 call, even though phone guy is dead, there is a message waiting for you. And it is, I can't remember how it is, but it's jarbled up. Claimed to be a famous sentence from a yogi book, where it essentially means that iron is alive, essentially. I probably butchered that whole thing, but I don't know what the exact sentence was, but the translation of it was that the animatronics are actually alive. Which is a decent bit of detail. At least I think so. Oh. Foxy poked up, and I checked rather quickly that time because I keep hearing footfalls, and I think you can only hear those when they move from the three rooms right outside your door. So I'm goddamn nervous. Sue me. Good thing I checked the light again, because I was about to say fuck it to that. But yeah, as you can see, it doesn't matter how close to the door they are on camera. It's if they're right outside your door, you put the door up, or door down. A lot of new people I've seen done that, and that's just a waste of power. And I did think it was clever with Five Nights 2 that they had essentially 11 animatronics, and they gave you complete power, which is something people constantly complained about, but they also had to give you a task. Huh? Sorry, thought I saw the camera flung out open. But they gave you a task where you had to use the camera, so more animatronics. Still a task that harrowed you. And yeah, it was difficult. This is, well, fuck it. I can just... I can honestly just sit here for a bit and wait. I mean, I don't think I have enough power to keep the doors down for the entire time. Freddy just moved. There he is. Wait, I know I don't. They are... Okay, Chica, gone. Bonnie, gone. Boom, boom. Well, Chica's probably not there. Damn it. This one will be iffy. 9% power left, and 5 a.m. I suppose we could just check on Foxy and 1, 2, 3, 4. Hear 4 deep laughs, and then, that one always creeps me out. If we hear 4 deep laughs, then we know that Freddy is right outside our door. Oh boy. This got us into quite a pickle. I think we're going to have to rely on Freddy taking his time when it comes to the marionette. Yup. Oh, and the going limp thing doesn't help with this. It doesn't extend it in any way. It's completely randomized. So, he is taking a while with that. I'm... Alright. So there you go. That's the first 4 nights. I've already explained to you what to do night 5, 6, and 7 if you have a difficult 7th night. So, we'll just listen into this phone call quick, because this is the very last phone call that you get on this game, and it is rather jarring to hear. So that was interesting. Alright, I want to thank you all for watching. Greatly appreciate it. If you could show your support and leave a like, comment, share, or if you haven't yet, subscribe to my channel, I'd greatly appreciate it. Thank you once again for watching, and have a good day. And good luck with Five Nights at Freddy's. Goodbye.